Hello, my name is Anthony and I would be solving this exercise with you. So you have 6 resistors. Each resistor has a resistance of 10 ohms. And we want to find a connection between these 6 resistors to obtain a total or equivalent resistance of 10 ohms. Before I solve this exercise, I will explain some things that you need to know just to be able to know this exercise. So first, when we have 2 resistors or more in series, so they can be 2 or more, and you want to find their total resistance, you simply add. So if you have 2 resistors, one has 10 ohms and the other has 40 ohms, to know the equivalent resistance, you simply add them. 10 plus 40 is 50. If I give you a third resistance, let us say of resistance 10 of 20 ohms, and if I tell you to find the equivalent resistance, you would say it's R1 plus R2 plus R3. So it would be 10 plus 40 plus 20, and this would be 70 in this case. So that's the first concept. The second concept, you need to know how to sum 2 resistors that are in parallel. When 2 resistors are in parallel, you may use this shortcut. R equivalent would be the product of these resistors divided by the sum of these resistors. So if I take 10 and 40 ohms, if R1 is 10 and R2 is 40 ohms, there is a formula which is 1 over R equivalent equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. But when they are 2 resistors, like in this case, there's a shortcut I would like you to use. You do 10 times 40 divided by 10 plus 40. So you get 8 ohms. So as we can see in parallel, the resistance decreases. In series, the resistor increases. And the last concept you need to know is that if you have n identical resistors, they have to be identical. They cannot be like in board number 2, one is 10 ohms and the other is 40 ohms. They have to be identical. So if I have, for example, 4 identical resistors and they are in parallel, that formula only applies when they are identical only, then R equivalent is R divided by how many resistors we have. So in this case, we have 4 resistors. So 4 resistors in parallel, when identical, have an equivalent resistor of R over 4. So in general, if you have N identical resistors, you divide R by N. So if you have 5 resistors in parallel that are equivalent, that have the same resistance, their equivalent resistor would be R divided by 5. So in this example, if R is 20 and you have 4 resistors, then you do 20 divided by 4, which is 5 ohms. So now, how would I solve this exercise? So remember, we have 6 resistors. These resistors have identical resistance of 10 ohms, and we need to come up with a combination that gives me a total of 10 ohms. So how is this possible? You have to try several circuits, and I reached this circuit. So I have 10 ohms, then in parallel, 10 ohm with 10 ohm. That's the first branch here. And also in parallel to this branch, I have a second branch that consists of 3 resistors. Now, why would this circuit give me a total resistance of 10 ohms? Let us check in board number 5. So the first thing you can do in the first branch here is to do 10 ohms and 10 ohms because they are in parallel. So you may find them using 2 ways. You either say it's 10 divided by 2 because they are identical and we have 2 resistors, or you may use the shortcut 10 times 10 divided by 10 plus 10. In both cases, you would get a 5 ohms. So here we can replace these 2 resistors by 5 ohms. And in the second branch, we have 3 resistors in series. In series, we add the resistance. So these 3 now give me 30 ohms because 10 plus 10 plus 10 is 30. And these 2 up give me 5 ohms. So now I have 3 resistors. This is 10 and stays 10. This is now 5 ohms in orange, and this is 30 ohms in blue. So if we go to number 5, that's now my new circuit. Now I can see that 10 and 5 are in series. Therefore, I can add them. So these 2 now can be replaced only by 1 resistor whose value is 10 plus 5, which is 15 ohms. So I now have 2 resistors, as you can see in board number 6, 15 ohms and 30 ohms. How can I make them one resistor? I use the formula R times R divided by R plus R. If you do this, you would get 450 divided by 45, which is 10 ohms. So I used 6 resistors with different combinations to answer the question that you have asked. I hope you understood it, and I wish you all the best.